And today, the main problem is school. The children go to school, they teach them absolutely something. They sometimes they confuse in the house, and
that's right. That's right.
Okay.
That's right.
Then, if you catch the little children,
yeah,
and try absolutely to put them in the right way,
yeah,
we may have done something great.
Yeah, alhamdulillah, that's what we do. Alhamdulillah.
Our job is not easy.
It's not easy. Right, you're right. Yeah.
Talk to the parents.
We have a big job.
Parents, very small.
Yeah.
Start with the parents. I mean, you cannot lead your children in the wrong way, with the wrong path, and when they grow up, when they're 20, you come and say, oh, children,
may Allah bless you, uncle.
You.
Yeah.
Start with them. When they are
yeah, young, صحيح.
الأبناء أهم شيء الأبناء.
صحيح.
أنه يتجه نحو أبنائك.
صحيح.
وعلمهم الآن.
صحيح.
قبل أن يكون عمرهم 20 عام. عشان. بعدها.
بعد قدام لا يصلي.
لماذا لا يصلي؟
إيه صحيح.
لماذا لا يعبد الله؟
صحيح.
لماذا؟
لا عمي عمي حتى بعض الأحيان الوالدين لا يصلون أصلاً.
لا.
بعد الأحيان هذه مشكلة.
نفسك.
نعم صحيح. 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 شو يا سلام عليكم. ويجينا خيمان. هاي ديو ناقي سلامكم. هذيك سلامكم. Yeah, بارك الله فيك على النصيحة محمد جزاكم الله خير. You're right 100%. We have like what I do, like what I do to my daughter. I teach my daughter, I said, look Aisha, when you wear hijab, you're not wearing it for me. When you want to pray, you pray to Allah, you're not praying to me. So don't wait for me to tell you to pray. Why? Because you want to teach your daughter or your son, because I'm going to die. So if I die, خلاص, you don't pray anymore because my father is to me to pray. No, you pray because Allah created you. You belong to Allah. You know, when you teach her that, inshallah, or when you teach your child that, when they come out, they will not take off their hijab. Because you say, oh, my father cannot see me. You see, because she knows Allah can see her. And she's wearing it because of Allah. That's why we have to teach our children. Not just beat them up. Even Islamically, you're not allowed to do that, to beat them up, break their bones and so on. So we have to teach that to our children. And may Allah aid us. Especially like our uncle said, this time we're living in is a time of fitna. May Allah give us ikhlas. But we have to understand, brothers and sisters out there, let us be proud of the Quran. The Quran full of logical arguments. Allah mentioned about the kuffar, disbelievers, when he brought that. وَضَرَبَ لَنَا مَثَلًا وَنَسِيَ خَلْقَهُ قَالَ مَنْ يُحْيِي الْعِظَامَ وَهِيَ رَمِيمٌ قُلْ يُحْيِيهَا الَّذِي أَنْشَأَ أَوَّلَ مَرَّةٍ وَهُوَ بِكُلِّ خَلْقٍ عَلِيمٌ. When the arrogant mutakabbir came to Nabi عليه الصلاة والسلام with some old bones and he crushed them into pieces. He said, oh Muhammad, you claim your Lord can bring it back into life? Allah said, say the one who's going to bring it back is the one who created it in the beginning. Qiyas al-awla, na'am. Min bab al-awla. Likewise, Qiyas al-awla, the one who created the heavens and the earth is able to create you.
More easier.
أَأَنْتُمْ أَشَدُّ خَلْقًا أَمِ السَّمَاءَ بَنَاهَا رَفَعَ سَمْكَهَا فَسَوَّاهَا وَأَغْطَشَ لَيْلَهَا وَأَخْرَجَ ضُحَاهَا والأرض بعد ذلك دحاها أخرج منها ماءها ومرعاها والجبال أرساها متاعا لكم ولأنعامكم فإذا جاءت إيش؟ فإذا جاءت الصاخة نعم فإذا جاءت الصاخة here the day of judgment the day of resurrection. So the point here is Allah mentioning his the thing that he created as a proof for his existence.
Huh?
No, no, فإذا جاءت الطامة الكبرى. Yeah, فإذا جاءت الطامة الكبرى. Yes, it's not الصخرة. الصخرة is the عبس وتولى. This one, النازعات غرقا. والناشرات نشطا. Yeah.
أخي شمس الدين, another point related to what you just said,
yeah,
your advice. This is related also to a methodology of studying aqeedah,
صحيح.
A way of discussing with atheist people.
Yeah.
Some people think that it is enough for them to study cosmetics and philosophy, then
بارك
he
الله.
Will be very capable to discuss with
atheist.
And he's making tawam in aqeedah
Allah.
While he's discussing.
Allahu Akbar.
Another thing, Ibn Taymiyyah, he studied philosophy of Yunnan, he studied aqeedah of Ash'ari people.
Yeah.
He was full of knowledge on that aspect.
Yeah.
However, when he mentioned the best way to discuss with Ash'aris or to discuss with atheist people, with atheist people, the best way is to use Quran. From
Quran was Sunnah.
Quran arguments, yes.
Allahu Akbar, sahih.
With Ash'aris, the best way is to use Athar Salaf.
Do you know why, Akhi? I was sorry to cut you because we have organization. They teach brothers just to study cosmology, philosophy, and they think it's enough to debate atheists. Do you know why? Because we have dunya, the imbitah. the inferiority complex because you don't have confidence to tell him, listen, Allah said, أم خلقوا من غير شيء أم هم الخالقون هل أتى على الإنسان حين من الدار you are not confident. So we tell him, Richard Dawkins, Stephen Hawking, Sam Harris, Lawrence Krauss, Peter Atkins, there's no harm used after, there's no harm showing of contradiction in their beliefs, but the us is the Quran. This book, if the Quran is not enough for these people, nothing will be suffice with them. Wallahi, the Quran is Wallahi, akhi. The Quran is sufficient. However, there's no harm to bring analogies because the Quranic way to mention analogies, Prophet Muhammad alayhi salatu wasalam, when a man came to him to show you that from the prophetic way to his analogies, that's why I use a phone as analogy sometimes. You know, the Quran, wallahi, when you read the Quran, read Surah Al-Hajj, read Surah Qaf, read Surah Al-Nazi'ati Gharqa, read Surah Abasa, read Surah Wattur wa Kitab Mastur. You know, read the Surah and you see the power of the Quranic verses in your heart. Because philosophers, they're too arrogant to accept their God. Why? Because they say, I'm a person who have PhD from Oxford University and I'm gonna follow a man that from the desert. That's the aqliya. You know, philosophers, these people, they will not submit to Allah. Even for the sake of argument, even if they accept Islam, they will not submit wholeheartedly. Because they have the arrogance, how can I do this? You know, like one of them, his name Anthony. I'm not sure if he's here. This guy, he said, huh? I say, yeah. He said, you cannot be certain. This guy, if he become Muslim, can he become Muslim? He cannot. Because to become Muslim, you have to have what? Al-yaqeen, certainty. So this guy, he cannot become Muslim. But of course, he utilized anything for the sake of rejecting Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And you see some Muslim, what they say? You see some Muslim, when they see you utilize the Quran and the Sunnah, say, no, he should be speaking to the other brother. The other brother, he knows about cosmology. Guess what? Anthony has been speaking to the other brother for nearly 3 years. Anthony became worse. In the beginning, it was okay, Anthony, you know? This guy, when he spoke to Anwar, then he started coming more and more because we entertain his argument instead of telling him, listen, stop, Anthony. You're going to die and you're going to stand before God. All this psychological, biological, not going to benefit you before your creator. When the death come to you, the queen, she had the best doctors. When the death come to her, no one saved her. When the death come to you, you see how you're going to be. That's when you say to the angel of death, psychological, biological, you know? And we don't say we should not study psychology or biology, no, you study it. But you cannot utilize this science to reject the most obvious thing, and that is the existence of Allah, and it should be worshipped alone. Look at our own creation. You know, everything has a purpose. Some atheists tell me no. I said, you're a liar, because why? You atheist scientists, they keep studying the world because they want to know what is the purpose of that. If there's no purpose, why are they studying the world to begin with? Because they have that. Something within them tells them everything has a purpose. Subhanallah. You know? So everything has a purpose. So either this universe was created by randomness, blind matter, or was created by the creator who possesses knowledge and a power and ability. أفلا تعقلون. Don't you not use your brain? أفلا يتفكرون. إن في خلق السماوات والأرض واختلاف الليل والنهار لآيات لأولي الألباب. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned within the creations of the heavens and the earth and the alteration of a day and night, it is a sign for people of understanding. People have a sound reasoning, not this poisoned brain, philosophical poisoned brain. You know, the sound reasoning is a sound reasoning that you utilize it according to its nature, and that will lead you to believe in your creator. Barakallahu feekum. So sahih, akhi, wallahi. You see some of the akhi, they go study philosophy, then he makes great mistakes in aqidah. Quran and sunnah. We utilize the Quran, no problem. What you do, sometimes you take the argument from the Quran and use your own wording for it. Like the scholars did, tafsir. You know, Ibn Uthaymeen, mashallah, Usul Iman, you told me to go through it. Mashallah, it's a nice book. So my brothers and sisters, may Allah bless you all. Let us use the Quran and the Sunnah. And like I said, there's no harm if he's bringing doubt to refute it. But sometimes some doubt, you should not even refute it because it's self-refuted.
Yeah, exactly.
You know, like one of them told me, this universe was created by one cell. I mean, come on. Give me a break, will ya? How on earth have I become English in it, brother? You know, from East London now. Listen, on earth, one cell created this tremendous, beautiful creation. I said, deep down, you know, it's a lie. It's not true. I'm not going to entertain it, but a cell, you know, we have a cell. Now forget all of that. Deep down, you know the truth. And you know, Anthony, he did come pray with me. Because some people said, no, he came. He prayed with me. After he finished the prayer, he said, we cannot be certain. I said, Wallah, sadaqallah, you know, Allah spoke the truth. Some verses will increase the iman of the believers and will increase the disbelievers in their disbelief. Adaban, punishment for them. Because why? Because they reject the truth. In the beginning, Allah tried them with misguidance more and more. May Allah protect us from misguidance. Wallah, ya khwah, too much, ya akhi. Hours, brother speaking to someone, no one verse from the Quran, no one hadith. Why? Inferiority complex. Cosmology, biology, yeah, that philosopher said this, the other philosopher said that, and that scientist said this, that scientist said that. Hey, Quranic way, strike the heart. If the heart is alive, because sometimes the person is alive, but as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned, لا تعمل أبصار ولكن تعمل إيش؟ لكن تعمل القلوب التي في الصدور. It's not the eyes blind, my brothers. They can see this creation. It's the heart is blind. Naam, is their heart is blind. It's Allah salama wa al-afiyah. So you think all of this proof of Allah's existence is not enough for them? And the proof from the Quran is not enough? It is enough. But they pretend to not understand. Abu Jahl. Wallah, some people, even if you bring Prophet Muhammad alayhi salatu salam, will not convince them. Why did Prophet Muhammad also convince Abu Jahl? Because not, the problem is not with Muhammad والسلام, or with Nuh. The problem is with them. They are arrogant to accept their creator. So you scare them with the fire. Say, fear Allah, you will die. When you're going to...
We don't do enough of that, man.
No. Wallah, I'm telling you. I've noticed. Remind them, you're going to die. How many people left their house and never come back? How many people won't sleep and never wake up? You cannot even defend yourself from the death. And you claim that you are creator, you don't need the creator. As one of the scholars said, Allah humiliated the people with death. When humiliate mean, it's humiliation for some people, but it's an honor for the believers. Because when you die, you meet Allah Jalla wa Ala. But it's for you, you're going to be humiliated because Jahannam after. Na'am wal'iyadu billah. We don't do that. And that is the Quranic way. Because why we're not confident? Look to the verse in the Quran. وَقَالُوا اتَّخَذَ الرَّحْمَنُ ولدا لقد جئتم شيئا إدا تكاد السماوات يتفطن منه وتنشق الأرض وتخر الجبال هدا أن دعوا للرحمن ولدا وما ينبغي للرحمن أن يتخذ ولدا. الله أكبر. They claim that the most beneficent have a son. You come with the most evil statements. If Allah allows the sky and the earth to show their feelings toward this evil statement, the sky will split, the earth will split, the mountain will crumble into pieces. And it's not befitting for the most beneficent to have a son. That's not the nature of the Most High. That's the nature of human beings and the creation. Barakallahu feekum. Ma fiya ya. Ma fiya. Huwa hayyakum Allah.